Hey guys, what's going on?
Hey, who is this?
Hey, it's Tig.
Tig, man.
Tig, man.
From WPH. Yeah. All right.
Yeah. How's it going, man?
Good, good. Well, we got you here. Let's talk some wrestling, right?
Yeah, guys, we're ready for Hell in a Cell this Sunday, man. What do you guys think? It's going to be great.
Yeah, Jonathan, I mean, what's on there? This is Taker versus Brock. This is number three, right?
Yeah, this is the final match between the three, and it's inside Hell in a Cell. So, you know as well as I do that anything can happen inside that Hell in a Cell.
Well, what do you guys think is going to happen here? Because I'm having a hard time figuring out what the ending is going to be on this. I mean, SummerSlam, you saw how that... I wasn't happy with the way it ended on SummerSlam. You know, I'm a big mark for Brock Lesnar. And the way he went out, you know, at SummerSlam, basically he... Undertaker put him out, right? He couldn't continue. He was out like a light.
Yeah, what do you think, Jonathan? I mean...
You know what? I'm in the same boat as Tig. I'm a big Brock Lesnar fan, so I'm really hoping that he kind of finishes this once and for all. I think that really there's nothing that Undertaker gains from winning this match. So I think Brock has everything to gain, and Undertaker has nothing to gain. So.
Yeah, it's Suplex City versus Low Blow City. I mean, every time we've seen The Undertaker go one-on-one with Brock, or at least in recent memory, he's been kind of giving Brock some low blows. And I mean, I guess that makes him the bad guy this weekend. So this is the last and final, maybe final. They're saying that it's the last one. But yeah, I think Brock has to be the beast incarnate and come away with a victory this weekend, Tig.
Yeah, low blows, and let's talk about terrible tombstones. I'm sorry, but Undertaker cannot deliver them tombstones like he did once back in the day. I'll tell you, Kane these days even does a better tombstone. What do you guys think?
Absolutely. I think that Undertaker's showing his age, and you know, there's no denying what he's done in the past, but there's really nothing left for him here in the WWE.
Yeah, the time isn't on his side right now, so I don't know if he can't go any longer, or you know, is this his last match? I don't know. I mean, I don't know what you do after this match, after Brock wins. I'm predicting a Brock win anyway, but I don't know what he does. What does he do after this?
Well, Brock's, you know, he said on the podcast, the Stone Cold podcast there, he's going to be around for a few more years, he kind of led everybody to believe. So he's definitely in for the long haul. I can't see what Undertaker's going to do after this. So wouldn't you think this is basically going to put the nail in the coffin for Undertaker and maybe send him out to pasture? I mean, what do you think?
Was that a pun intended or not?
Sure, pun intended, yeah. I don't know. I can't see Undertaker winning this one on Sunday. You know what I mean? I mean, like you say, I don't think he's got anything left to prove, and I don't know how it would benefit him. I don't think, you know, I think he's heading towards retirement here.
Yeah, and I mean, we're getting close to 6 months away from WrestleMania. So, you know, it's I don't know, is it his last hurrah? Is it his last ride? I don't know. I mean, this could be the beginning of the end, maybe. It could be, you know, it's the go-to-hell tour for Brock Lesnar, but maybe this is the goodbye to the dead man tour. I don't know as well. We'll see, I guess, right?
No, we're definitely looking forward to it. It should be a great pay-per-view.
Now, Tig, is there any Hell in a Cell that really sticks out in your mind? Like, do you have a favorite Hell in a Cell match of all time, or do you just enjoy watching all of the Hell in a Cells?
Well, they're always great. You know, I was talking to my good friend Joe Mason about this, actually. He's another big wrestling fan. He loves you guys.
Sure, yeah, we know Joe.
Yeah, Joe's a great guy. Been going to wrestling for the past 30 years, and a lot of the past 30 years I've gone to wrestling with that guy. And we were trying to think about cage matches that we saw, or even if we saw a Hell in a Cell match. And he brought up that we were in Hartford, Connecticut, No Way Out, Hell in a Cell in 2000. Triple H versus Mick Foley, who was Cactus Jack at the time. And that stands out because that was a brutal match. You guys remember that one? It was a lot of bloodshed that night.
Yeah, that was they ended up on top of the Hell in a Cell with the flaming 2x4 wrapped in barbed wire, if I remember correctly.
There was a lot of craziness going on there, and both guys were covered in blood. I mean, it was a crazy night. Hartford Civic Center for that, and that would probably stand out most. You know, that would be the only one that I attended, Hell in a Cell match. But talking about, you know, the standard cage matches and all, was never a big fan of the big blue cage. I know a lot, I think you guys like that cage, right? With the
Old school blue cage, that was real steel. You know, if you saw guys using that today, they'd probably really hurt themselves because there's no give in it at all. So it was pretty brutal. But, I mean, it was definitely a staple back in the day of a cage for WWE, at least.
Yeah, I enjoyed, though, the old school style, like where Jimmy Snuka did the dive onto Don Morocco, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The old standard steel cage. That was always my favorite style, if I could choose. But there were some memorable matches in the blue cage, like Hulk Hogan versus Bundy. Wasn't that in there?
That was.
Yes. WrestleMania.
That was a good match.
Now, Tig, I mean, you're a staple in Poughkeepsie, New York. You're a staple in the city where we're from. I mean, do you remember any memorable moments at the Mid-Hudson Civic Center that you attended as any wrestling event?
Well, you know, I was there for a couple of the TV tapings back around 85, 86, around that time. That was when I first started getting into wrestling, and my uncle took me and the kids to a couple of the matches. Nothing in particular stands out as far as great matches, but I remember, you know, bearing witness to Piper's Pit, a couple of them, and, of course, the late, great Roddy Piper. That was always entertaining to me and always loved watching Piper's Pits, and to see it live in person was a lot of fun. So that would be one of my favorite memories of the Civic Center back in the day, is getting to see Piper's Pit being recorded for live television.
Great. Well, Tig, I mean, it was short and sweet. We can call it a little bit of outside interference from the Tig Man tonight. but, you know, we barely talked to you. We're going to talk to you more in the future, but Tig Man, thanks for popping by.
Yeah, sorry to interrupt, guys. You do a great show, though, and looking forward to Sunday, man. The pay-per-view is going to be great. It's all roads lead to Hell in a Cell this Sunday.
All right, Tig, we'll talk to you soon.
All right, take care, guys.